Hey everybody, I'm SK and welcome to this hour, who knows what episode of the Hunting Grounds vlog. I am here at the Oakwood Cemetery, the crematorium at the Oakwood Cemetery, and I'm going to back right up here so you can see the sign. There it is. That's where we are. And I say we because I am here with guests. Who are we here with? We're here with Don and Mary.
And we forgot our stupid telephoto lens, so that picture of a gargoyle is gonna suck.
They're trying to get a photo of the gargoyle. Where is he? There he is. Oh, look at that.
Damn it.
That's the gargoyle on the this is a crematorium.
We'll have to get a steel picture of it.
Oh, I should probably zoom wide before I'm making everybody sick. So we are here at the Oakwood Cemetery in Troy, New York. And this place is immense. So I'm gonna pick back up a little bit later. We're gonna do some walking around and I'll see if I can get some nifty photos and some video footage here for you guys of this awesome cemetery. I'll take this back up in a minute.
We'll both be making them.
So Don and I are sitting here contemplating how we are going to build these gates. These are the gates on the crematorium. And how we're gonna build these gates out of PVC. You know me, I can build anything out of PVC.
Yeah.
So this may be the next quest. It's going to be interesting if I decide to tackle this.
So let's see. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, how many?
And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
So that's 150 of those circles. 150 circles. And then we have to drill 4 holes in each circle.
Yeah.
So that's 600 holes.
Now, how many nuts and bolts do you need? That's the key.
600. One nut and bolt for every hole.
Oh, yeah. Duh.
So there we have
well,
it.
Well, no, you wouldn't need, because in the here, you'd just be putting these into the wood.
Into the wood, right.
So you could knock off 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 there. Knock off.
Oh, look at those hinges.
Yeah, the hinges are pretty cool too.
That would definitely have to be a foam project, I think, maybe.
Too bad you couldn't come down here with a mold kit.
I know.
Molded on the wall. Then pour
groundskeeper's like, what the fuck are you doing? Nothing.
Well, you know, you just take some clay.
Yeah.
Push it onto it.
Yeah.
You know, and get it all nice and pushed on there and stuff real good. And then just peel it back off carefully and then take it to your car and mold it.
I'll just get a box full of Sculpey. I'll make a wood box full of Sculpey. I'll come over here and be like, push it in real quick and pull it out.
Yeah, there you go.
All right, let's see, there's another one over here. So just think, that's just one of the gates. Think of if we were to replicate this as an entryway to a haunt. That'd be fantastic.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool.
There's another 1,200 more circle, or 1,200 more holes to drill.
Hey, somebody drilled them.
Right,
and they didn't do it through PVC.
No.
They did it through like steel.
Yeah.
So that ups the ante right there.
Poor asshole.
And they did it in 1888 for crying out loud. So they didn't have a drill press.
Look at that hinge. That's fantastic. I like that.
That's the ladies' restroom.
Oh, that's.
We have to change that.
Hey, ladies. Anybody have to use the bathroom? What? It's got one of those old
Look at the detail on the wood too. It's all that. It's got that crackle. Yeah. Or is that wood or is that iron? No, that's wood, I guess. But it kind of looks like it's peeling.
Yeah, look at that. The texture on that wood.
That's like Gina's orange peel kind of.
Yeah. Wonder who I missed. Oh, it was Carly.
We're vlogging, Carly.
Wait, are you there? Holy shit. I pocket answered you.
Notice they removed the originals and they put on new. Because look at the outline where they
have
the originals.
Are you here? And now we picked up another visitor. Look at Carly start to back up. She's like, oh no, don't. And we're wandering amongst the tombstones. That's kind of cool. It almost looks like a skull there. At the top of that. Huh. You can see off in the distance, you can see the crematorium that we were just at. So we're not very far from where we started. And there's a lot of old and a lot of very ornate tombstones in here. So I'll try and pick up video of some of the more unique ones here. But I'm not gonna run this video for too long because you don't wanna watch tombstones forever. A lot of statues in this cemetery as well. There's that little thing of flowers. It's kind of cool. Yeah.
Around the corner.
I just spotted this. We're really in the same spot I just was, but I love that font that they're using on these stones. And they're raised. You can see here. So what I would do, if I was gonna do this, is get a sheet of that foam that you can buy right there at the craft stores, the thin foam, and then cut the letters out with a knife and glue them onto the stone. And the other thing that these have is on the top, mother, father, and Harvey. I'm guessing Harvey must, what is Harvey?
I think it's Harvey.
Harvey?
Harvey.
All right, folks who's watching this, what's up with that? What is Harvey?
Oh, look at.
Oh.
Maybe it is Harvey.
Oh, there you go. Harvey. John. Oh, John and Emma.
So Emma was Harvey.
Yeah, Emma.
Oh, no, yeah, these are Harvey. They're all Harvey.
Yeah, but why?
I don't know why they put that on there.
That's kind of cool. So
these have the dates on top.
Yeah, there's another idea for you. These have. That has a time frame, 1868 to 1897. This one actually has a date, which I'm going to have to assume is the date of death, based on the.
Oh, look at the back.
Other stones.
Symbols on the back.
Oh yeah, look at that. That is pretty wild. Another couple interesting little ones here. Those little flowers laying on top. And this one, as you will find, is quite common in here. The anchor. Right? Why so many anchors here, Carly? Mm-hmm. Why so many anchors here? Because these are all, these are a lot of the maritime folks.
Or just the anchors.
Right, there's one right on...
oh, I see one, okay.
On that stone, and I know that there's a few...
There's a giant one near the water.
Yeah.
Of a captain.
And there's a couple of them, a couple of the statues actually have... let's take a look. Let's take a wander down here. Trying to give you guys as much food for thought and inspiration as possible for your tombstones, your tombstone projects. And I know some of you have projects going on right now that you're working on. I know, let's see, Lydia Rossi has been working on some pretty cool stones. So I'm hoping that we give you guys lots of food for thought here. And this is probably going to end up being a fairly long vlog, just because the sheer size of this cemetery. It is massive. There's a nice mother and father stone.
I like that one. I like that. I wish I could make out
what it said. Let's see. Can we see what it says? Can we get it? I don't. I can actually see it on camera a lot better than I can see it. I'm going to try and decipher this after when I'm watching the video, because that is really cool. And I think that you can actually see this a lot better. The life, I can see the word, I can see the life right here, the life. And I can see that really well.
This looks shell.
Hearts, is that heart? H-E-A-R-T, I think.
Yeah. Does it say
though? T-H-O-U-G-H, though. I don't know, it's hard to see. I see the word dead. Is that? No, that's not dead. That's heart. That's heart again. All right. We're going to have to decipher this at home, but. John. Is that 11-6? 22? That's really hard to see. I'm looking at the picture in my... picture on my thing. So I'll see if I can decipher this when I get home. But that is really cool. And there's some really, it's just a really nice look at some unique weathering. And we're going to see a lot of that in here. Just a really great variety of weathering. There's so many different types of stones, so many different types of stone within here, within the cemetery. And you can see stuff like this here. This stone here, sometimes there's really just not a lot of rhyme or reason behind these dark streaks that run down the stone. It's not a part of the original stone. It's definitely later weathering. But what's that?
Noble.
Oh, look at that. We found nobles. I'll have to let Christy know. And she can... Lydia Noble. Hiram R. Noble. Ransom H. Noble. These are some kind of...
That's a cool name.
That's some kind of original names here. So she should be able to track whether or not there's any line. All right, I'm going to stop this. I'm going to stop this and we're going to move on to another section. And another quick look at a... interesting stone. This one is very small. This was an infant that died at 8 months and 20 days. And you can tell just by the size of my hand, that's a very small stone. Here's some more kind of ornate older stones here. Again with the mother and father. And more. Look at that beautiful weathering. And look at this. What a view of the cemetery from here. Some really great decorative work on some of these stones. And this one has birds atop it. And you can see they're pretty well worn. A lot of these stones don't hold up well to the weather. This one was 1861. This stone's been sitting here since 1861. And I believe it is marble. But I'm not positive. I know marble doesn't hold up well to the weather over a long period of time. So that is really cool. All right, we've lost Don in this immense cemetery. I'm not sure where he went. Oh, there he is. We found him. Well, that was relatively painless. Limestone?
I think that's limestone, isn't it?
I don't know. That's kind of cool. And I said earlier that it was granite. Or I mean marble, but I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I know.
I don't know, feel it. It's
really cool. But I know, and that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking that I'm not good with stone identification. I love tombstones.
Would marble really like?
I think it does.
Age like that?
I think it does. That's really cool. I did a little tiny bit of looking into what old stones are made out of.
Yeah.
But I never really did a whole lot. I know that, you know, like the older ones, the really, really older ones generally are like slate or there's only a couple of stones to use. The slate for some reason just lasts like a long time.
Yeah.
I'm taking that right there. I'm going to be using that on a stone. Until the day break and the shadows flee away. There's a line for a tombstone.
Yeah.
This stone is really cool. I have no idea what any of it says. And who knows, maybe again we'll be able to read it better. The video, but really like that. It's really nice, and it's got a stone that accompanies it. That's almost like a little casket. Again, it's not really readable, not legible, but that's kind of cool. And some of this footage may show up again. Somebody's in a hurry. Some of this footage may show up again in another video, because I'm actually doing this and I'm filming two separate videos at the same time. So. So we are, like I said, I'm filming two separate videos. Some of this stuff will be contained in both videos. But that's really cool right there. You can see how this stone has worn. The sides of the stone have broken away. And it's broken completely through. Looks like maybe it was epoxied back together at some point. There's some kind of goop there. And it's really not legible. There's just quite a bit of the stone. It's just worn right away. And here's the stone that accompanies it. That was a wife of. You could tell that one said the wife of. Oh, look at that. It's beautiful.
You don't believe that's a stained stone.
No, it's worn away. It's been glued back together. Look at that. It's kind of... You can see it's not straight.
They've both got rounds, but it's not
the
same stone.
Well, no. It's. I mean, it's the wife of. It's a couple's stones.
That's why I'm saying.
They're identical except for the text that's on them.
Yeah.
But the bottom doesn't look that way.
It's because it's so worn out.
This one's worn and fallen apart. This one's still together. They were probably cut at the same time.
You think so?
Yeah, because they're husband and wife stones. Husband and wife stones are always cut together. One's left blank when the one dies, and then they fill it in when the other one dies.
That's got to be creepy.
Huh.
That's got to be creepy, knowing that your tombstone's already set for you.
I know. But that's how differently they age. This one is worn away almost completely.
People that do that are smart. They're prepped it. Well,
nothing wrong with preparing for the inevitable, right?
Yep, we're all headed back to the community.
There is a really lot of cool tombstones in here. Don, what do you think?
A lot of tombstones.
Lots of inspiration.
Of,
lots of inspiration, yeah, that's what I was going to say. Lots of famous people. Lots of famous names. Yeah. Gene Simmons is buried right there. Or he will be.
Maybe.
Well, he's from New York, right?
I think he is. I believe so.
So, that could be him. Well, he ain't dead yet, but, you know, right. Somebody in his family's dead.
That, I'm just going to get right up close to this. So, hey everybody, that concludes our trip out to the Oakwood Cemetery. I think we had a good time. Mary, did you have a good time?
Yep.
Don, did you have a good time?
I can't see you.
I know you can't see me. Come in, because I'm in the other room.
The stick. Hi! Is it showing me? Yeah,
yeah. Did you have a good time, Don?
Yeah, it's alright.
Yeah, it was alright. So anyways, we did a lot of other recording. I took quite a bit of video that I didn't include in this vlog, and I'm going to try and put together a little montage of our trip and throw some music behind it and so you can get a look at some more of the statues and stuff and some of the tombstones that we didn't share in this video. So be sure to keep an eye out for that. And that's it for now, so... Until next, thanks for watching.
Pleasant dreams.